new friend. You mentioned that Paul Twitchell had the Rod of Power. Then the guides gave it to you. Was there anyone before Paul? Dwayne responds, Rebazaar and the real guides decided this position through eons. In other words, they developed themselves to eventually have what Paul termed the Rod of Power. It was always there, and has been related to the world. People have their experience of it, but don't have the whole experience. And there's a lot more. It takes time. If you want to become a doctor, it takes time to be so. You just can't suddenly be so. The Rod of Power always existed. It's just that it was time. I'm not saying it was the right time, just it was decided to do it. This transference was given to Paul, so he would have more capability to provide what he did, have the awareness, etc. It's a backup. It's like having a battery in your car, but all of a sudden you're given a super battery to drive really fast. And so that's the Rod of Power idea. The Rod of Power is very interesting, and in 2001 I was finally ready and took it. But then I stepped back after a year or so, because it was a lot. There was more to do, more to learn, and so in 2007 it became the new wave is, and this is a completely new spot, you might say. The Rod of Power exists, but only in creation, and the new wave is everything. It's the isness, because it's awareness. The Rod of Power is exactly that, and the guides wanted me to change everything with it, which I did, and I even changed the levels according to what Paul did. Because this is a real and new Awesome opportunity, like never before. And it's the risk-taker position, because you're going into the unknown. People may claim to have the rod of power, but it doesn't exist anymore in the sense that it did, and this is the fallacy of it, and again, its power. The power idea is in creation, and yes, we need that. It's like you power your car, or you get up and want to be a powerful athlete, etc. The whole of life, which I see, this isness, is awareness, and that is through everything. You still have to deal with your personal self. You have to face yourself. You need to figure out yourself, personal self, identity, etc. So you have a really good comparison to better understand this. For the most part, people approach this like they would religion or a spiritual path, which I understand. But this is not it, and there's a whole lot more to it that's not seen. It's not confined and condensed like those things are, especially with the spiritual love idea and the God idea, the angels, saviors, and other things, as those are really set-ups in creation. In the books, I call these designated heavens, like the astral and mental worlds where people will go. People have been designated to go there, and they will be designated to come back. It's the same old cycle. The rod of power idea has always existed, but it becomes a little bit too much for society as it is. The guides take a chance with even bringing it out because there are repercussions, because with this rod of power is cause and effect in creation. You're always dealing with cause and effect. The guides also have to be ready to handle the effects, because they have to deal with it, and this is where, when you have the real guidance and you have tap lines, the guides come in and start removing these things. Again, you're dealing with cause and effect. It's very touchy here in creation. It's not like we think, to where you just think a thought and it becomes so. It's like saying, when the chemtrails are above, that you don't believe in them, so it just cancels them out. Well, it really doesn't. There's more to it than that. People are going to get frustrated over these ideas, but they need to take the time to learn, or they don't, and they just keep being frustrated. I would become more frustrated over the chemtrails, the vaccines, the 5G. How just by starting your car, you're poisoning yourself and everybody else. But it's funny how most people are okay with this. It's become a standard, and it's nuts. What we're presenting here is to finally recognize what's going on, recognize where you are, and what you're in, and what you can do about it. This is why I call it the real cure for all, and I have fun with that. The real cure is to recognize your real awareness and get on with your journey and support those that are doing so too. You learn from others also. The real guides push this along to where people get together and better understand. Like when we get together on our Skype meetings, because there's a lot to sort out. Look at your personal self. Take the time, every moment, to watch every thought and impression that you decide, and those things that you react to. Who will take the time to do that? And for the most part, the personal self will consider that everything it's doing and thinking is fine, is it? You have your cell phone, your car, life's good, and everything's fine, but you don't see how overall it adds to the demise of everything. But yet it's fine to the personal self, because it's self-satisfied. I'm not saying that's bad. I'm just saying that's what's taking place, And do you want to keep going with that until you're 99 years old, pass out and forget you were here? Or do you want to decide something different and take on the challenge, the adventure, and the risk to provide something that makes sense? You always have that choice, every moment. The questions people have become excuses to do nothing much of the time, and so the end result will be they will get nothing.